May 1st, 2024. If you look at exactly 12 o'clock in the night in the east direction, you will see the Scutum constellation just above the ground without any telescope. You know, what's the weirdest thing about this constellation? Well, last year in September, when an Australian research team was detecting some radio signals in the night sky, you know, so that some common objects emitting radio waves such as neutron stars to detect pulsars or their magnetically stronger siblings, magnetars, then surprisingly they saw a mysterious radio signal coming from the direction of the Scutum constellation, which was not matching with any known object. And you know what's worse? This signal would continuously flash for about 5 minutes and then suddenly disappear and come back after exactly 22 minutes. Now, first of all, an undergraduate student had discovered this weird radio signal for his ordinary college project, not for a serious purpose. Actually, the story of this signal starts with another signal, which was found in the year 2020 by an undergraduate student of Curtin University in Australia, Tyrone O'Doherty. Doherty was working on a project under which he was identifying the unknown blinking radio signals from the old data of Southern Sky. Now, during this project, he got a radio signal from the data of 2018 to the Earth. So when he told his mentor, radio astronomer Natasha Hurley-Walker, about this beam, he started researching this signal himself. First of all, he looked at the location of the signal in different frequency data, but unfortunately, he didn't get any clues about the signal there. But then, he saw a pattern hidden in the radio data. He saw that this signal is repeating every 18 minutes. And so, she immediately knew that it could be a game-changing discovery of her career. But unfortunately, before she could study the object in detail, that signal disappeared within just 3 months. Meaning now, only one thing was left to know that this object 15,000 light-years away from us is exactly. So, in this discovery, Walker and his team first started matching this mysterious signal with all the known objects that emit radio signals. And surprisingly, they saw similarity in old data and this signal. There were many radio signals in that data that were blinking exactly like J183910, and that blinking pattern was repeating after some time. So when they researched the source of these other similar signals, they found out that all the old signals, the typical category of neutron stars, were emitting from pulsars. Now friends, this is interesting. What happens is that when 10 to 25 times bigger stars burst from the sun, instead of becoming white dwarfs, they turn into smaller, super dense neutron stars. Now some neutron stars have such a massive mass that due to gravity, their matter starts collapsing within itself. This compresses those stars and their size becomes smaller. And so, to conserve their angular momentum, these stars start to rotate very fast. It's just like when a ballet dancer pulls her hand inside, then her speed of rotation increases. And such rapidly rotating neutron stars are called astronomers' pulsars, and they are more dense in comparison to neutron stars. And because of this dense environment, the neutrons present in the pulsars decay in electrons and positrons and start to rotate fast on its surface. And now, friends, you tell me a simple question. What is created by a moving electric field? Yes, a magnetic field, and the particles present in pulsars, like electrons. As soon as they come in contact with this magnetic field due to being charged, they get accelerated in its direction, and during this time, they throw their energy out of the star as radio waves. But the magnetic axis and its rotation axis of pulsars is not always the same. Just like in the case of Earth, its magnetic axis is tilted at an angle of 11.3 degrees from the rotation axis, and this is the reason why, when pulsars rotate on their rotational axis, then the tips of their magnetic axis, which emit radiation, periodically point towards our Earth. Meaning, we can say that pulsars blink from one side, which is exactly like our strange signal. So, now what does it mean? Finally all done. Mystery closed. Well, when astronomers studied pulsars, they slowly realized that they were on the wrong track from the start. Because usually to study pulsars' behavior, scientists calculate their pulsating period by how many times they are being repeated, so that they can predict how long the pulsars will be alive. And so, did the radio signal we got recently really because of pulsars? To find out, scientists plotted all the pulsars they have seen so far on the basis of their rotation period in this graph. Now, the pulsation period of normal pulsars is between 0.25 to 2 seconds, and that's why all the pulsars come here in this region. But because of the continuous rotation, eventually the pulsars start losing their energy. And now that the energy has decreased, obviously its rotation speed will also decrease. And if the rotation speed decreases, then its pulsation period will increase. And in this case, the pulsars will move in this region, which astronomers call Death Valley. As the name suggests, the countdown of the life of the pulsars begins as soon as they reach the Death Valley. And basically, the pulsars of this region's rotation rate slows down to such an extent that they are able to emit radio waves in a very small amount of time. And when those pulsars cross this death line, their rotation slows down to such an extent that they are unable to emit radio waves anymore. But when astronomers plotted the signal they got in this graph, they were just baffled. Because, as you can see, this signal was emitting radio waves even in front of the death line. One thing was certain from this, that this object is definitely not a pulsar, but then, they were struck by that pulsars also have a special category, magnetars. That is, stars whose magnetic field is 1,000 times more than a normal pulsar. Also, they show a slightly longer pulsation period than pulsars, and that's why scientists thought that maybe these kinds of stars could explain this signal. But when they plotted this star in this graph, they saw that it was not even close to that signal. Because magnetars are highly energetic, they emit X-rays along with radio waves. But they found that this signal was emitted only by radio waves. And that's why astronomers had to rule out the possibility of it being a magnetar. Meaning, all in all, the signal given to scientists neither a pulsar nor a magnetar. And it was clear that the radio signal recently received was not matching with any known object for astronomers. And so, according to them, this signal is still a long-standing mystery. But friends, when we were researching on this topic, we came to know that apart from pulsars and magnetars, there is another special category of stars called white dwarf pulsars, which can possibly match the strain signal. Actually, white dwarf pulsars are such white dwarfs that pulsate like pulsars. By the way, white dwarfs are formed by the rupture of a star with a sun or less than its mass, and usually their magnetic field, pulsars, is not as strong. And that's why they don't pulsate. But when white dwarfs become 0.8 times as massive as the Sun, they become so dense that they become pulsars. They also generate a strong magnetic field. The only difference is that where neutrons decay in electrons in pulsars, white dwarfs are originally made of electrons. So as soon as these charged electrons come in contact with the magnetic field, they emit periodic light flashes like pulsars. The pulsating period of pulsars is only 100 to 1,000 seconds long. And now, if you remember, the period of the recently received signal is 22 minutes. If I convert it to seconds, the period is 1,320 seconds. Meaning even though this value is outside the range of white dwarf pulsars, but in comparison to other pulsating stars, this is the closest match of this signal. And that's why, friends, if you ask me my opinion, I personally feel that maybe this mysterious radio signal is coming from a white dwarf pulsar. Meaning this is how you can understand that there are so many things in this universe that we still can't fully understand, like even supernova explosions, for example. You all know that when a small white dwarf explodes, there is a type 1 supernova. And then when a star 8 to 40 times heavier than the Sun explodes, there is a type 2 supernova. But recently, scientists have found such a mysterious supernova explosion called the Scary Barbie explosion, which has been throwing out 100 times more energy than any supernova explosion in the past 3 years, and it is not fit in any of these types. Now, if you want to know about which explosion I am talking about and why it is called Scary Barbie explosion, why it is so dangerous, then I have already made a video on it, which you can click here and watch. It's very interesting, and it is also a mystery of the universe. And if you enjoyed today's video and got to learn something new, then don't forget to like it. And subscribe to Mindful Journey channel and press the bell icon so that you don't miss any of the upcoming videos. And keep on increasing your knowledge. See you next time, friends. Take care. Bye.